Hello and welcome. In the previous episode, you saw how I picked up a Performa 450, which unfortunately had some keyboard problems. So now, let's clean up and fix that keyboard. To clean this keyboard and hopefully fix it, we're going to remove the keys and some tips. Before you do this, I used to, back in the day, put this on a copying machine and got a photocopy of it, and then I immediately had the keyboard layout. With the modern technology, you can just make a picture with your cell phone, of course, but don't forget to do that. Because you will end up not knowing exactly where which key goes. So make that picture. And second tip is get one of these. This is a keyboard removal tool. It is very cheap. You can buy it on the internet, on Chinese websites. And it is really helpful to remove these keys. And let me show you how to do this. So, I'm going to remove all these keys. Then I can clean them up and get all the dirt behind them. And then hopefully I'm also able to fix these sticky 6 and 7 keys. Or sorry, 7 and 8 keys that are lower than the rest, as you can see. And the space bar, which is also not working as it should, and that of course has a different mechanism with a metal hinge behind it, but just be careful when you remove those keys. So I will be back in a minute when I've removed all these keys. Now that I removed the keys, you can already see all the dust that has accumulated over 27 years. The space bar is held in the middle, and I have to be very careful when I remove it, as it actually already has a small crack in it. I managed to remove the spacebar by slowly and carefully applying force upward. The cone behind the keyboard is different in color from the cones behind the other keys, being yellow instead of beige. It is the same size though, maybe it is supposed to have a different sturdiness. I gave all the keys and the cones a good wash, and decided to put them back after that. Using the yellow cone, the spacebar is still not working properly. So I swapped that out with one of the other cones. And now the spacebar, it works like a charm. So which key do I sacrifice to put the yellow cone behind? Well, the key that I think is used less than others is the clear key on the numeric keypad. So I will sacrifice that key, putting the yellow cone there, and making that key the less responsive one. So here is the before picture, and here is the result after some cleaning and fixing the keys. Cleaning the cones also solved the minor problems we had with the 7th and 8th keys. Not sure where those cones ended up, but all keys worked great. And even the clear key seems to be not as bad as the spacebar originally was. So I'm very happy with the result and saved another Apple ADB keyboard from retirement. So the keyboard for our Performa 450 is now ready and working. Remember that it also came without an ADB mouse, and
I started hunting for that ADB mouse and I came across something very interesting that will certainly solve that. In the next episode, I will show you how I found a big collection of Apple stuff, including several interesting Mac computers. This brings an interesting twist to our story that has so far only focused on reviving a single Mac. So stay tuned. Thank you very much again for watching, and stay safe as well.